Thanks very much, Lori. And I am hungry because on such a cool autumn day, we are warming up right now with some wonderfully simple comfort food. Maria Felice, the author of Breaking Bread in L'Aquila, is back with us. We love it when you come because
you just fill
the table with food and food that's very, very, very easy to make.
That's right. What I wanted to do today, and it's great seeing you, Annette, is really get back to basics. If we look at the table display, it looks so overwhelming, but folks, we're cooking today with butternut squash and apples. What I wanted to do is show you the different types of squash, and when you're in the grocery store, don't just walk by. Mm-hmm.
And you know what? I'll admit that that's what I do because it's like, I don't really know what to do with it. And it's Ontario produce as well, you know, locally grown, but it's like, it's kind of intimidating almost.
And that's why I wanted to show it today. In fact, what I had my dad do last night from his garden, he cut open a butternut squash for me. So this is what it looks like. And what you're going to do is you're going to scoop out the seeds and then cube it. Sure. And then you're going to cube it. It's going to look like this. And what I did today, this dish was inspired. I was in Bologna a couple of weeks ago, and I had pumpkin tortellini, and I had this fabulous dish of roasted butternut squash with toasted pine nuts and sage. And today I just wanted to show you how simple this is. I made some farfalle pasta, which is the short bow tie. I thought it would be festive on November 1st. And basically, you're going to cut up the squash, cube it, just roast it at 375 for about a half an hour.
Just till it kind of gets tender.
It gets
but not
really
too mushy, right?
It's got to be semi.
Okay.
Okay? And then it's going to look like this. So now what I'm going to do here is just put this luscious butternut squash with pine nuts and a little butter.
The bowl holds everything here. I'm going to let you do this.
And basically, what we're going to do is just mix. Look how pretty this is. And then we're going to, I always love freshly grated parmigiano. And look how easy that is. It's perfect.
Now, is this recipe on your blog?
I'm going to be posting this week all of butternut squash and apple recipes in my blog is foodandfaith.blogspot.com and email me. The other thing I wanted to show you is how to use apples as an appetizer. What I did was I cut up an apple and I wrapped it in prosciutto. This is fantastic.
Ooh,
the sweet and savory, as well as smearing it on a little goat cheese, some cheddar. And folks, when you cut up apples, make sure that you squeeze a little fresh lemon juice so it doesn't brown.
You can make it ahead of time kind of thing, but
yeah.
And I mean, like, how much do you just squeeze it over the whole thing?
Just squeeze it over so it coats it just slightly, not too much, because then it's gonna be too bold. And for the kids, and I actually love it myself, is a little afternoon snack with a little peanut butter.
It holds you over.
It's fantastic.
I know, it's great.
Really, really great.
And they're full of fiber and so abundant in our area. We
absolutely
grow fantastic apples
absolutely
in this area. And then you have some baking. This is so simple to do. I remember doing this in grade 8 home ec.
You know what? Apples.
Baked apples.
So easy. I love anything with apple. So what I did was I took some Granny Smith apples and some Northern Spy. They hold really well in the oven.
Yes.
The ones that don't and they kind of lose their shape, I can relate to that, are the Macintosh, okay?
Right.
They kind of shrivel up. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to core your apple, and I have a core instrument in the front. Invest in one, folks.
Yep.
Invest in an apple core.
This one here.
Okay. Then you're going to stuff them with raisins. And I love nuts, so I like to put some pecans, and then just put a little drizzle of brown sugar, so you'll see how it just caramelizes on top. Now, don't be afraid to use other things. I have for you dried cherries.
Ooh, yeah,
I have,
that would be great.
Like dried cranberries are fun. I've also stuffed them with chocolate chips.
Oh, that's a
good
idea.
Some chocolate and apple, okay?
Very good idea. You know what? We've run out of time. So, food and fate. blogspot.com is Maria's website. You've got lots more on your, of course, your book, your fundraising book, Breaking Bread in L'Aquila.
That's right.
Which is still a huge fundraiser after the Italian earthquake there. And we're going to have you back just before Christmas because we've got to start thinking about holiday baking already.
I look forward to coming back next month.
Okay, Maria, pleasure to have you
on. Thanks for having me.
And we're back with more news at 8:30. Stay with us.
Great.